Hello everybody, Shadefire here, and welcome back to Let's Play Dead Rising. This is episode 17, and I believe this will be the last episode. For real this time. No more extra unlockable post-game modes or anything like that. Well, at least this will be the final main episode. There is something that we'll probably check out as a bonus, in case I don't forget, like I did with some other games, which are still in the backlog. But so in the interest of making this episode not super long, I actually went and collected the remaining queens we needed, as you can see here. Now that I've done that, we can just kind of hand them in. I figured that would be more interesting than having like 20 minutes of running around looking for the right kind of zombies. Another 5 queens. Oh, I might have actually gotten an extra one there. I thought I needed 7. She just reaches into your chest and pulls out a queen. Some sort of anti-zombie vaccine, you say? Something perhaps like Zombrex? Alright, here it is, the final queen. Now she can blend them up or whatever it is she's gonna do.
You're gonna inject me with that, huh? Okay, Doc. Let's get this over with. At least I won't have to worry about turning into one of them for a while. Okay. Next on the agenda. Figure out a way to get the hell out of here.
While I was isolating the hormone, I managed to identify a pheromone that suppresses the attack instinct in adult parasites. In other words, the zombies don't like the way it smells. If you give me a little more time, I should be able to produce some of this pheromone.
They think it smells bad? You think we could use something like that to keep them away from us? We could just walk right past them and get out of here.
In theory, yes. Either way, it's certainly better than nothing.
It was a cave. Outside, where the helicopter crashed. It was packed with zombies. I mean, shoulder to shoulder. But it may lead somewhere outside. If it works, Your anti-zombie perfume. It could keep us safe in that cave. What do you say? You ready to get the hell out of here?
There won't be enough of this pheromone to waste it on experiments. We'll only have enough to use it once.
Whatever you say.
It's been a while since we heard the main Dead Rising theme kick in.
My God. There are so many. Where on earth could this lead?
I don't know, but considering how many of them keep pouring out of here, it must be connected to something. Isabella, look. Any other way out of here is guarded by the military. If we're gonna get out of here and put a stop to Carlito's plan, we've got to go in there. It's the only way. It's not like we're unarmed. We got your smelly perfume, don't we? I wouldn't be alive right now if your shot hadn't worked. The perfume's gonna work too. I know it.
All right. Let's go.
Yeah.
So, pretty much as soon as you give Isabella that final queen, you're at a point of no return because the game immediately teleports you here, and you can't go back. So anything you have in your inventory is all you have left to carry you through this area. Now, we don't really need too much in the way of weapons, because as you can see, her perfume does keep the zombies away. Actually, it probably is a good idea to save here.
Right.
But yeah, so if you're not prepared here, because, you know, you left your inventory open so you could collect a bunch of queens, and this part can be kind of rough. Especially because there isn't really much in the way of weapons in this tunnel, aside from some rocks. Alright, let's see here. Let's save over this one. But I brought my mini chainsaw, which, as you saw in the queen collection bit, is not one of the weapons that doesn't spawn after overtime mode starts. I thought it was, but then I wired by there and I saw it. So I grabbed that, and I grabbed a book, so that should be really all we need in terms of weapons here. So we can hold hands with Isabella, and when we do, you can see it knocks over any zombies that get close to her. But we do actually need to split up with her so we can get through areas like this. And we're not protected while this is happening, so, you know, bust out the chainsaw. I probably should have grabbed some help, but again, my inventory was full of queens. Whoops, did not mean to do that. Alright, so we pretty much just have to escort Isabella through here. I didn't mean to do that either. I just wanted to go like that. Wow, that was like 7 zombies in one stomp. Come on, Isabella. You still kind of have to deal with the wonky survivor escorting when you do this. Oh, that's a dead end. But yeah, as you can see, there are a shit ton of zombies here. since this is pretty much the main source of zombies getting back into the mall. Why they're coming all the way through these tunnels? Well, it's still pretty unclear. And look, here are the only weapons the game will just give you. Some rocks. I think there might actually be a pickaxe in here somewhere, but just one. Queens are also very effective in this tightly packed area. Alright, yeah. So we got through the first section.
Yeah.
Well, we got a bit of a problem here. You might have noticed that her little potion glow is getting smaller. So, it's actually kind of losing effectiveness here. And zombies have to be much closer to her to be effective. I didn't hit right mouse. How easy it is to take damage when there's this many zombies, though. You know, a smack here, a grab there. Chainsaw's already nearly breaking, even with the book. Is that another queen? No, it's just a hunk of meat. Come here, Isabella. Unfortunately, even with her potion, she basically still has the same survivor AI of, if there's a zombie near me, I'm going to shove it. So as long as we can kind of rub zombies against her, they'll fall over, but if they bump into kind of that middle where our arms connect, we'll basically do that. Come on. It's all downhill from here, Isabella. God damn it.
Once we're out, let's see if we can't steal ourselves that set of wheels.
So there's another save point here, but I'm not sure I really want to save with this little health, because I didn't bring any orange juice or anything, which I really should have. Oh, it can be a real pain in the ass to even try to pick her up. I could have sworn there was a little bit of health around here.
Oh.
So I have a feeling I'm going to have to do this whole run again if I die here. But that's fine. I actually completely forgot to grab health because of that cutscene. Normally what you'd do is you'd hand in all except for the last queen, go get the inventory you want to bring with you, and then go back. Let's see if I can grab this guy's queen here. Not quite what I want to do. God damn it. I tried to throw it over to that crowd, but fucking Isabella was in the way, so I just threw it at her. I think she doesn't care. Oh no. They'll be too distracted by the zombies to see us. Alright, but let's just skip over that old tunnel bit. Alright, so here we are on the same spot. But this time we're considerably better equipped. As you can see, I've got two shotguns, a chainsaw that's not even broken yet, and two healing items. Which is good because all we need is to use these until we get to the truck, and then we won't need them anymore. Getting through that tunnel area that I went through earlier is much easier if you use a lot of queens. Because basically, if you throw a queen, it will kill all of the zombies except for the other ones that have queens, so you can actually just kind of queen hop from queen zombie to queen zombie without actually having to use up any of your items. Where is it? I hear it. It's here somewhere. Oh, there it is. Don't want to use this here, though, otherwise it will kill the zombies that will distract the special forces, but we'll use it here. Still kind of maybe killed too many of them. But if we give the special forces a minute to kind of engage the zombies, which you can see have already respawned anyway. Did she just shove me from being carried on my back? Alright, I think we can make a break for it now. Oh yeah, there's the healing items I was thinking of. There's a couple apples here. We just have to get in this truck and it's, we're home free. Of course, we need Isabella here too. I mean, it's pretty much clear, Isabella. You know, relatively speaking. So yeah, for some reason, that clock tower had this giant-ass tunnel that led into this, like, reservoir system, which seems entirely too huge for that small town that we saw to have. It's a good thing we never had to deal with that rough-looking military man from that one cutscene. But for some reason, the military had a tank, a prototype tank, deployed in this reservoir system. So now we have to fight the XM3. So most of the time we just want to be shooting these flashing green lights, which do something. But when we get to this little laser comes out, you want to shoot that because that is how it targets us with the main cannon. Oh shit. Okay, there we go. So yeah, it's like a weird automated tank. It's basically just a automated Abrams. Which is why it has the XM prototype name. fairly easy boss, though. We've got this mounted gun. We have no control of the vehicle. Isabella just kind of circles around the arena. And this is pretty much our final boss. So you can see why we really didn't need our weapons and stuff. Because they pretty much just give you your weapon. As we saw there too, sometimes it will deploy a cloud of drones, which are mostly just a distraction. But you can see they go down in like one hit. So this is really not a tough battle. And of course, on the PC, it is much easier to keep your gun steady than it was with just a controller. I suppose, really, every game will have a turret section, even when least expected. This is one part where he can fuck you over, though, when you go around that turn, because it still locks on even when it can't see you. So as it's going around that bend, it'll lock on and then fire as soon as it comes around the corner. And also got these missiles, which we can shoot down. Again, not a big deal. Not really sure where the missiles come from. It clearly doesn't have any missiles, like, mounted on it or anything. I mean, as far as I'm aware, Abrams don't typically have missile pods mounted on them, but then again, this is a fancy made-up prototype, which is for some reason being used to quarantine this town. Got him. There's this fucking turn again. See what I mean? There's nothing I could have done to stop that because the fucking camera was hidden. But it only did one damage. Our Jeep doesn't seem to have its own health. And there it goes. Because, you know, a Jeep with no defenses is totally adequate against a tank.
These automated machines are no use at all on the battlefield. Switch to manual control.
I mean, he's got a point.
Aim main cannon.
Oh, shit.
Well, what have we here?
Now, if it was realistic voice controls, he would have had to say it like 3 or 4 times.
Where were you hiding when my men mopped up the mall? On a mission in which the number of targets is unclear, it's difficult to ensure absolute thoroughness. Huh. You have imagination. That's what drives you in your quest to run, your quest to hide. As prey, you and your kind are much more stubborn than the zombies.
Baby, I was born to
run.
How much
do you know about the zombies?
I commanded the Santa Cabeza cleanup operation. If we had fulfilled our mission then, we wouldn't be needed here now to take care of this incident.
That's all it was to you, huh? A mission. What about those innocent people who had to pay for sins committed by our government
and its inhuman research? Our mistakes have not begun with this operation. Humanity has proven itself to be quite adept at making mistakes. Ha! Hell, it's the only thing we truly excel at. Well then, I'd say this mission isn't quite over yet. Don't you agree?
So the real final boss fight is we have to fight Brock here, on top of a tank surrounded by zombies, with nothing but our hand-to-hand combat attacks, because we don't have any weapons or health or anything. So you better know your fucking techniques here. Also, you can see he will block most of our attacks. Still does a little bit of damage, but not much. Isabella's here, but she's pretty safe up there. He'll just stand here and watch while we get beaten up by zombies. No chokehold for you. Try to do the leg sweep, but you have to jump and then click as you land. Yeah, you block that too, son of a bitch. Explored this area. Oh, did we learn a new fighting technique that we can use on him? Somersault kick. I don't remember how to do that one. I'm trying to think, like, what moves would be good against him here. This fight always gives me some trouble. Also, because we leveled up, I got my health back, which will be handy. I mean, really, you have to try to hit him after he attacks if you want to get some hits in without him blocking. Because I'm still doing damage, but, you know, it's a lot slower than it would be otherwise. Tackle. It's control space. Just keep slapping at him. Unfortunately, none of our grab-type attacks work on him, as far as I can tell. Oh, shit.
Oh,
You can see that even when he falls down, he sort of like auto-teleports back up. Oh, I actually hit him pretty good there. Got him. He's tough, though. He can actually be pretty challenging the first time you play this and not expect to have to fight someone hand-to-hand. And that's why you don't crowd surf. Frank is victorious. And once again, we're left with a kind of downer ending. A bit less than before, since obviously they're both still alive for the moment, but they are trapped in an area surrounded by zombies. I guess Frank could maybe figure out how to use the automatic tank and get them out of there. And, you know, it's not really a spoiler to say that they do get out of there, since canonically in the other games, Frank is alive and is taking Zombrex to deal with his infection. Though I believe by the time of the fourth game, the whole zombification thing has been completely cured, so Frank doesn't need to take Zombrex anymore. But yeah, that's Dead Rising for real this time. And it's still a game that I very much enjoyed, and, you know, still, I will always be on my list of favorite Xbox 360 games. And I'm glad that they re-released this on PC, because I think this one is just maybe not better than the later games in some ways, but in other ways I think that this is a different game than those, and it's kind of a good thing that it is. You can definitely tell that this game was made by, you know, an in-house Capcom team, a Japanese team, versus all the other games which were made outsourced to, you know, I believe it's all from a certain studio in Vancouver, which is just Capcom Vancouver now, but it was like Blue Moose or something like that before, which just don't have some of the charm of this game, I guess. Like, you know, Dead Rising 2 and 3 and so on try to outdo themselves with the whole wackiness. Look at this, I taped a fucking sledgehammer to a to a fire axe and now it's some sort of super weapon. And then 4 kind of goes completely over the top with, oh, you've got power armor and you can kill 100 zombies with your bare hands in 10 seconds. But none of them really match the, almost to a degree, unintentional wackiness of this game. You know, like, this game kind of tries to be serious when it's not being serious. I mean, sure, there's a lot of dumb shit you can do with the, you know, sticking servbot heads and wearing crazy Frank in a dress with a fucking lizard head for cutscenes and stuff. But that's all wackiness that's at the player's control rather than just like, oh man, look at these crazy characters we added. Oh, this boss fight's so over the top. I also like this zombie march for this credits here. But yeah. I'm glad that they released Dead Rising again on the PC so that people who never played it could play it and maybe get a taste of something different than what the other games in the series have done. And yes, there is the time limit thing, and I know that's always going to turn some people off, but I really think that this game benefits more than it is harmed by having that time limit, because, again, it wouldn't really be a great game if it was just like, hey, take as long as you want to get through this. Doesn't matter. Because there's not really a lot to do in the mall. Like, later games in the series, yeah, okay, I can see why maybe they might benefit from less of a time limit, because there's a lot more shit crammed into the edges. I don't remember there being a lot of zombie models with glasses, actually, now that I'm looking at these. I mean, I guess they must have been, but you never really look at them that close. Anyhow, I hope you guys have enjoyed this run-through of Dead Rising. Now we can see the stuff that I unlocked by the achievements I got in that playthrough. Megaman boots, Megaman tights, Special Forces uniform. Well, we already did overtime mode. We also unlocked it infinite mode, which I guess I'll do a little video on. That is the mode where the infamous 7-day survivor achievement comes into play, which is where you need to play the game for 14 hours straight with no saving or checkpoints or anything. And need to constantly hunt for food, because in overtime mode, in addition to not having a time limit, you have a health limit instead, where basically every 60 seconds, you lose one health square, and you have to constantly hunt around the mall for food, and all of the infinitely spawning food points aren't there anymore. There is a limited number of food in the mall, and a lot of it you have to get by fighting psychopaths, so it can be tough. I mean, obviously people have done the achievement, even back in the day when doing so risked red ringing your Xbox, but it's maybe not the most fun thing to do, especially since a lot of it ends up being like, go out, collect as much food as you can carry, then stand around in this spot and eat it when you need to fill up to certain amounts, and then do something else while you're waiting for your health to drain down before going back to the game. But we'll check it out. Die horribly because I never actually did it. And you can see, Frank West managed to escape, so somehow the two of them managed to escape that situation. And the U.S. government was like, yeah, maybe we accidentally created zombies once, but that has nothing to do with what happened in Willamette. The people of the world, as could be expected from the modern culture of news saturation, soon let the Willamette incident fade from their minds. And thus was forgotten for, like, an entire game. I really feel like that was supposed to be sort of a sequel hook, but then they couldn't think of a way to really integrate that, so they just like, oh, fuck it, we'll just make another outbreak. Because apparently in the Dead Rising world, zombie outbreaks become a pretty common thing. Of course, it's later revealed in Dead Rising 2 why that's the case, but it's still kind of funny that there's a whole bunch of them, and it's like, we might be involved, says the U.S. government. And I guess at some point, Isabella's formula ended up with the company Phenotrans, which is the only company that makes Zombrex in the future games, which is basically, a drug that people who have been infected by the zombie wasps have to take every 12 hours so as not to turn into a zombie. Anyhow, that's it for the main playthrough of Dead Rising. As I said, there is a few little bonus things I like to do. Maybe we'll take on the convicts as a side thing, because I never really did that in this playthrough. And maybe check out a few other things here and there, but otherwise we are done with the main story. And I enjoyed playing through that, and I hope you guys enjoyed watching it, especially if you hadn't seen Dead Rising before, which sounds like a few of you hadn't. It's not, like, the best story or anything. I mean, it's a Capcom story, but it's maybe a little less obnoxious than some Capcom stories. It's not just like, I am a very bad man, and then the good guys are like, you are a very bad man, and I must stop you, and also punch this boulder. Ha ha ha, complete global saturation. Anyhow. I've been Shadefire, this is Dead Rising, and I hope you folks all take care and join me with whatever comes up next. Till then, have a good one, folks.